All right. So, what's happened last? All right. So I am recording now. If you guys wouldn't mind, because I got like nothing of our first session, would you mind giving a brief intro of your character, like, and what you're doing here and what you did last session? Let's go ahead and start. In the order we did last time with Joey.
Hey, I'm Joey the Mountain McGeezax. I am a gnome. I work for Mr. Erzova, who is a legitimate businessman. I brought my self-created lead shooting wand, as I call it, to a wizard who was doing unfair competition and attempted to persuade him not to do that. And long story short, I'm here on the other side of the world. I've got one hit point. It's no fun.
All right, Masko, if you would go ahead and introduce your character.
Hi, my character's name is Potter, and he is a traveling Saiyan who's basically lamenting about the fact how he crushed his girlfriend and not in the bedroom. And basically, he's on a journey of discovery and inner peace. He recently went to and instead of finding inner peace, he found that he now has a big drug problem. But I basically was trying to source an oracle to find a solution to his woes, and now he's found it in Kingdom Come.
The local.
And he's now recovering from the act of basically ingesting half the town's water supply in the river.
To those who do not know, the Kingdom Come is not a suggestive, although it is, not a suggestive thing. Go ahead.
It's basically one of Sala'Bhim's most potent narcotics.
There you go. And you had a big old glob last time still on your clothes, and why the hell not?
I thought, what's it? As in the word of the great Bubsy, what could possibly go wrong?
Alright, and next is Hanya, who is Alex. My Alex.
Yeah, my character's name is Hanya Shalsov, and she's basically wandering the sands of Sala'Bhim in search of her missing family members. She was part of a very political family of high power, but then there was like some big unspecified scandal that brought them all down, and now like half of her siblings are missing. So she's just kind of wandering the world and looking for them, and she just is being a mercenary and gathering info and kind of just a drifter. That's really all I have right now.
All right. And Corinne's Alex.
Mouth real full of pizza. Okay.
of course.
My character is, what did I call him? Garrick. Garrick is a sailor. He was a kind of mouthy pirate.
He was a mouthy Aussie when you met him last session.
Yeah, he does have an Aussie accent. He is a sailor who is trying to find work after getting kicked off of his previous boat. If somebody were to ask him, he would say he was higher ranked than he actually was, because he's kind of a liar. But he was currently in this city because the only job he could find was guarding a shop,
shop of weapons.
A shopping cart of weapons, like the marketplace. He was guarding somebody's weaponry as they were selling, and he kind of quit his job in a spectacular fashion last time. Mm-hmm. Some asshole customers were raising a fuss and trying to start a fight, and he finished it, and now he's drinking in celebration.
And then awesome. Corinne, please.
My name's Thorn. I'm a dragon. Rowl. That's my intro. No. I'm a sorcerer with dragon's blood, and I was kidnapped by a cult. I don't know when or how or why, but I escaped. And, yeah. That's it.
All right. Sounds pretty good. So specifically how this particular scene is played out is after Thorn escaped her captors, she sprinted down the road as fast as she could, trying to get away from the building that held her. She stopped at the town bridge that crosses the two sections of town between the forum and the administrative district. After she stopped to catch her breath in front of the bridge, from the sky, a lightning bolt fell onto the ground, and once the smoke and light cleared, there was a four foot one gnome. Just sitting in the middle of this small clearing that was caused by a lightning strike. Now that everything is kind of cleared off and the day has kind of returned, Thorn turns around, notices that particular tan orc over here who seemed to have orchestrated her capture along with what appears to be three hired goons around him. Otherwise, the teleportation of Joey was a rather big spectacle, and it gathered some attention, but now everyone's just kind of standing around dumbstruck, waiting for someone to make the first move. And this is just from commoners that I haven't really bothered to mark, along with the party and the bad guys over here.
I'm going to start limping towards the tavern while yelling loudly, "Little help!" Because I am very badly injured.
There are two doors. That little orange spot I made here is a door, along with this spot right here.
Okay, that's the closer one then.
Probably the closest for you.
Everyone does seem to notice him. Joey at the moment is very much the center of attention.
I'm guessing I'm still kind of like recovering after my episode.
For the most part, you're pretty much over it. I mean, you might feel some.
We were laying down by the riverbank pretty much.
For a while, yeah.
Yeah, so I think I've just like, I'll have noticed like, that's a particularly injured looking person over there. He seems to be shouting a lot of words. Mostly things that I wouldn't dare speak again in front of my mother.
Oh, I've seen stranger.
Really?
This is a very weird... You don't know my siblings.
Oh. Well, he does look very hurt, though. Do you think he might need help?
We could go check it out if you want.
Meanwhile, I'm like, duh!
Hold up. The door is right here.
Well, I figured they would see me. They can't see me, right?
I think everybody would see you if you went through a stone wall. Next thing you'd just be going like, oh yeah!
Oh, there you are, you little shit.
I hear the commotion of Thorn basically screaming her way through the door. Go like, yeah, I think we might need to check that out.
Alright. That was such a cozy spot to lay down to.
I know, but there'll be other cozier places, but let's go find out.
Oh man.
Alright. So, Garrick, you are just having a grand old time, just drinking your woes away. I'm going to say you spent a good silver piece, you think, on booze.
Okay.
That's quite a bit amount of booze. And they brought up the finest tap of, I don't know, what's your drink?
Probably ale in this situation.
Butterbeer.
Okay. So they brought up their finest bottle of butterbeer, I guess, just for you. And all of a sudden,
you whip.
A grumpy-looking gnome hobbles into the tavern you're standing in, along with a screaming woman. seemingly shouting at the top of her lungs, shouting nonsense about cults and the end of the world.
The end is nigh! Oh my god! No,
If someone could direct me to the nearest Temple of Zion, I am in need of a healer. I don't know what's happening. I will let you get about your business. Just need a healer.
Shit, I don't got any spells.
Give me a second. I'm just going to make a... You know what? I'm just going to draw.
Good lie.
I have minus two heal, but I think in your situation, that might not be wise.
Okay. This square right here is the bartender. Because I'm too lazy to look up a token right now.
Okay.
Can I square? There we go. Nope. Square won't move. anyway. The bartender looks at you, hobble in, and requests... Oh, there we go.
Ooh.
That's a handsome fella.
What you buying, stranger?
He looks at you and he says, "Oi," I guess everyone's got an Australian accent right now. I default to Australian. I said, "Oi, mate, there ain't no temples of Zion in this district. You and Sala'Bhim, mate."
I don't know what that word that you just uttered means. I need... Who is your holy man, your healer?
We got some clerics of the great sun god Duka down there, down the road.
Sounds like blasphemy, but I'll take it.
All right. Thorm, are you doing anything else aside from shouting your nonsense?
Oh, I've calmed down. It was really just shouting until I got into the tavern.
So are you ducked behind the door? Like?
Yeah, I kind of just ducked behind the door.
All right.
You there, warrior.
Warrior?
Yes, you are a warrior, are you not? I will pay you handsomely if you protect me.
What is it?
Just protect me.
Protect the party member.
I'm more than halfway through my drink.
I'm super rich. You know you want to protect me.
You're not the greatest liar.
I'll roll for that. Shut up. Hold on. I'll make you believe me. I definitely have something for this. Hold on.
Anya and Pata also hears this promise for gold.
Perception. I can make you believe me, Cam.
Money?
No,
I hear perception. Money is good.
Perception is seeing.
Money's not bad.
All right.
Excuse me there. I believe I heard money being exchanged.
Meanwhile, the villains wait patiently.
Brave warriors!
Brave warriors.
Alright. Well, warriors, that... I am a warrior, at least, so that's half right. And I believe now I'm failing on the former part. Now, do excuse me. Not really. Kidding. To say, and I believe this is why you were calling for these. But I guess you're having a problem here.
Please, I've been kidnapped by these terrible people, and I will pay you handsomely if you could just protect me.
Okay.
I'll protect you even if you pay me ugly.
Do I have sense motive? Because I want to see if I...
Yeah, if you've got sense motive or knowledge of local, I'll let you make a check now. My guy, he's just kind of looking amused at the situation, and the four of you hear this Tanork just sort of give a polite cough, and as you all look at him... Oh, damn. You can see that he is a fairly... He's rather built for a Tanork. You can see him and his compatriots are all armed fairly well. And they look and say... Oh. Yeah, the one looks and says... All right, here's my... I'm trying to think of a Southern or Cajun. Does anyone know a Southern or Cajun accent I can use aside from... Howdy, y'all.
Southern accent.
Do with the guy from...
I do declare.
I do declare. Now. Now, people.
Yeah, you also could do Foghorn Leghorn.
Now, people.
That's a joke, son.
That's a joke, son. There we go. I'm slipping into the southern. There we go. It's pretty stereotyped, but I think that's okay. All right. Wait.
All right.
He looks and he points a finger at the woman who's offering you gold, and he says, "Now that woman's a criminal. You don't want to protect a criminal in these parts. I know the sheriff personally." All right, Alex, you determined this to be a lie.
Yeah, and I have. Do I have it? I better have it. Aw, damn. Not really. All right. I want to pull out the wanted poster and be like, "You're darn right, buddy."
All right. The orc responds, sees the wanted poster, and let me see it. Let me do his knowledge of local, see if he recognizes you. He looks at the wanted poster, looks at you, then looks at Pata, and just kind of says under his breath,
"Take him alive! Take him alive! Take him alive!"
And I think that's a pretty good initiative. So, go ahead and move your... go ahead and keep your guys here, and then roll a d20 and add your initiative bonuses. It should be on the right-hand side of your character page, down under speed, I think. It should say Anish.
Okay, 7. So.
Where's my
initiative bonus? He just said it's going to be...
not finding it.
Okay. I can't find it.
It's going to be on the first page.
Oh, no. Wait, I think he said speed. Yeah, here it is.
I found myself.
Inish.
Plus,
yeah.
Plus
2.
Yay!
Holy crap.
Well, it's
only... Wow. Corinne, don't you have improved initiative?
I don't know.
I thought you took... I could be wrong. You might. I may be thinking of Alan.
Where is it supposed to be, honey? I'm not seeing it. I just want to know where it is so I can...
Put the 6 or the 2? Which one do I put?
It should be, like, just... It says a knit in, like, the bottom right-hand corner of the first page.
Yeah, it's that's the... That, and then... That
yeah, so I... Yes, that's what I got.
Okay. Right. All right. I'm going to do mine.
Okay. Oh, there we go.
It's just paper. Who cares?
Yeah, I know.
Saving the best for last. That's what I say. You gotta put a 1 in front.
All right, and then Corinne got... What's yours total?
Yeah!
Cool. You get to go second.
Yep.
Yay.
I got 9.
Okay.
Nat 20!
17.
And then Joey, what'd you get?
17.
Wow.
Here we go. I can change it myself. Cool.
Oh, you can?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, let's... is there a descending order? Oh, there we go. Descending. There we go.
All right.
So up first is Hanya the Bounty Hunter.
Yup.
Yes.
1 second, I gotta put my needle away. There.
Now don't stick that in your sister.
Okay, I am going to go ahead and swing at the main guy with my scimitar. Because he is right in range of me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and step in front of him and just directly swing at him for that.
Okay.
And it's... 2d4 plus 6. All right.
I am being defended.
Hold on.
Are you rolling or?
I had to double check my modifier.
Okay.
Ugh. That does not hit him, does it?
Right. You take a protective stance in front of the woman who was begging for help earlier, draw your falchion, swing with all of your might, but the man in front of you is surprisingly ready for it and like arches backward, avoiding your blade.
Yep.
Garrick, your turn.
All right. I step forward, going... kind of shuffle my way through the crowd, through Pata and Thorn, and step forward and swing at Deadman with my scimitar.
All right, go for it.
So exciting!
Hey, shush. Plus three.
Yay!
Heck yeah!
Oh, damn. Yeah. Okay. Not to split hairs, but you had to take a move action to get there. And you draw your scimitar. I probably should have mentioned that. I'm sorry.
No problem. Oh, because, yeah, I didn't.
You should add more than three to that, because don't you get full BAB?
That would mean that I get full. It's a plus four, so it's a 19.
Okay. All right. Unfortunately, like I said, you had to step forward and then draw your weapon, so that was a full action to do that.
Yeah, so I just saddle up in front and kind of take...
A really intimidating stance. But graceful.
Yes. I've been great, nothing but graceful on this
entire game. Exactly. All right. Big Bad's turn. He recognized the two bounty hunters, one who is the only female bounty hunter in the city, and the other one is the guy who's known for taking down people with his bare hands and using weird magic. So he's going to actually turn tail and take a full retreat out of the bar. He's disengaging rather than...
Yeah, I can move.
Okay.
He's not going to get far, though, if you want to try.
The big bad back.
He just kind of shoves his minion out of the way and then runs out.
Does that slow him down at all?
Huh?
Does that slow him down at all?
He can only move, so he can only take a single one, two, three, four.
Yeah, I'm going to...
You got a beeline for him?
No way.
I think... Isn't he a wanted man?
Chase people, right?
Yeah, but I'm not the bounty hunter.
I know.
He's got 1,000 gold bounty if he's caught alive.
I'm just happy that I'm protected right now.
All right, Joey, your turn.
Okay, this door that I'm right next to here, does it open in or out?
Let's say it opens inwards into the bar.
Inwards. Okay, in that case, I'm going to dive behind the bar and then start reloading my pistol, because it was... Or not start, but reload my pistol.
That's a good idea.
It was still unloaded from the last time.
Yeah, you just teleported from that situation, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm kind of out of the frying pan here, so I would prefer to have my pistol loaded, but beyond that, you know what? I don't really have a horse in this race. I wish you guys well, and I'm just going to hang here with my one hit point and my pistol.
All right. Let's see. Joey went, and didn't I use this token for an NPC? Draws his axe, takes a 5-foot step forward, and seems a little too excited to be attacking a woman.
Uh-oh.
Finish!
Girl.
Alright, he swings downward with his axe, and Alex, what's your AC? 18.
Should be. Let me double check.
Since you went first, you are not caught flat-footed,
yeah,
so you get your full AC to that.
Yeah.
you jump backwards as the axe just kind of slams into the floor.
Alright,
yay.
Mook 11's turn.
I get money in
then
the
I'm
marking
Mook 1.
Captured. I'm sure you didn't have much on you.
I don't know that yet.
He draws his sword, just kind of steps around like this. Let's see how let me see how far he can go. 5, 10, 15, 20, 30. Okay. So he will go here. Just kind of hang out for a bit. Pata.
That's weird.
Okay. I can't really do much from here, so...
After the move.
Get in range!
Well, I'm gonna get in range of, I think since he's now kind of, like, gone in the flank, I'm gonna, like, go after this guy, so...
Can you do that? Can you make all those moves?
Yeah, because I can move 7 squares, which is, like, 35 feet, so that's 15, 20.
You dove over the table, Dukes of Hazzard style.
Yeah.
No, I just go like, go over the table. Because I can do that, my dexterity is really good.
Yeah, I'm just going to give it to you.
Okay. I'm basically going to do this with some style. Okay, and then basically, I'm just basically going to attack him with punches.
Fair enough.
Yata.
Okay. Are you doing flurry or are you doing
Just standing. I'm not gonna blow my spell on a mook.
Fair enough.
So what do I roll?
You roll a d20 and then add your strength bonus basically.
Okay, cool.
So that's 7. Alright.
No. Shouldn't be that big.
Yeah, that's my strength. That's my strength mod.
What's your strength
now? Oh, okay. Oh, wait. Hang on. Yeah, I've still got the effect of Kingdom Come on me.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, because it's like a temp of 8. So I added dexterity. Okay, I can take that off. Okay, no, it's 3. Sorry.
Okay.
My bad. 14.
All right. You launch yourself over the table, thinking that this guy's not going to sneak around and get his way. You lunge forward, and he just kind of parries your fist with his sword. Just kind of knocks it out of the way. Huh?
Masaka! I was going to, like, the Japanese. Impossible!
Oh. Right.
Not all.
Nani?
Dead man goes next, and he's trying to set himself up for a better position. He's going to draw his daggers and take a 5-foot step over here.
He's gonna hit you.
And attempt to attack Garrick.
He defends. Depends on his
roll. He rolls.
I was gonna say, you know, you defeat someone.
All right, he lunges with both daggers, and you gracefully avoid them.
Yeah, that's right.
Thorn's turn.
Great, graceful pirate that I've ever met.
I'm the only pirate you've ever met.
You're supposed to do that with an Aussie accent there.
I'm the only pirate you've ever met. They call me Max.
Max. All right. It is our resident sorceress's turn.
Who's turn?
Who's?
Oh, okay. Yeah, we're up to
you.
This no, dead man.
Yeah.
Oh no, he just attacked you. Okay.
So it's your turn.
My turn.
Pay attention.
What should I do? I guess I could put him to sleep to help people.
Yeah, sleep. How many times did you get to cast that a day? Because you did that in your intro.
I think she did it twice.
Yeah, you did it twice in your... It was up
did
there.
Did I do it twice?
You did it twice in your intro, and how many times do you get it?
That's a good bunch. That's a good question. It only says level one magic, doesn't really say how many times I got it.
You should have it on your sheet. It should say times per day.
Okay. It's a first level spell.
So it's four? How many times do I get to use it?
Yep, you get four.
Yeah,
you four. Okay. So I have two.
Yep.
Two more.
Sleep! Yeah. Do I have to go closer to them?
No, it's actually you can actually move fairly far. Sleep is a very long range, or it's a medium range spell, which means you can hit them away from, like, I think 60 feet.
Oh, I should back up because they are after me. Maybe I should go behind the bar.
Sleep!
Oh, yeah, you can hit them.
How do I do the sleep spell?
Just cast.
No, I mean, like, dice roll.
Oh, yeah.
I roll will saves.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he just rolls for that.
Alright.
I'll put him to sleep!
Alright, let's say this one right here is fairly weak-minded, so I'll give him a negative one.
Because he's a mook.
He is out.
It just sounds like a term that...
No, that's a movie reference you didn't get.
From what?
It's from...
A dead man is still awake.
Damn it.
However, mook 11 has fallen asleep.
Oh, he is a dead man.
All right, now.
What's Luke from?
Garrick and Pata. Wait, I don't... No, you cannot control this. Garrick and Pata need to make will saves.
Okay. Wills. Will. Minus two.
Will is minus one.
Oh, okay.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Oh, nice job.
Oh, thank God for that.
Roll one.
Why is this?
20.
Man. Wow.
Not so graceful today.
Gracefully, Garrick falls to the floor asleep.
You wouldn't help me anyway.
I stepped forward.
You did not. I said, I was like, pray for you. Like, bugger off.
Bugger
off. All right. It's now Hanya's turn again.
And Hanya wants to go after Bad Big.
I think I went behind the bar.
Okay.
So, am I clear to pursue?
Essentially, either if you want to go after him this turn and actually attempt to catch him, you will eat an attack of opportunity.
Damn. Can't dex my way out of that one, can I?
Oh, do you have acrobatics?
Yep.
All right, you can attempt to get around it. Basically, yeah.
They go to the
go
bar.
Ahead and roll it.
Not serving.
And I think you got to beat like a... Let's double check how that works.
It's early Scorsese.
Is that good enough?
No.
I'm checking right now. Right now.
I always bark one down. Always bark.
All right, cross, uneven, move through threat. All right, here we go. Move through threat and square.
Yeah.
All right, five plus the opponent's combat maneuver. Oh, yeah. Their combat maneuver defense is awful. Yeah, you made it.
Yeah. And then my speed, I do what, 40 feet?
You're gonna go
after. No, yeah. You 30. You can make it by going diagonal here. 5, 10, 15,
20, 25, 30. 30. All right. Wow. And then do I get an attack or no?
Yeah, you can do an attack roll because you did a move action and now you can swing at him.
Damn it. My sword is not very sharp today.
Alright, Garrick, you are still asleep. Bad Big goes. He sees you sweeping at him. He kind of skips forward a little bit and then kind of takes a pause. He looks at you, gives a big smile, and says, "Oh, darling, you made a mistake."
Oh no.
Takes a 5-foot step back, pulls out a pendant from his basically breast pocket, mm-hmm. holds it up, and casts a spell. Can you give me a
will save?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sleep.
That's all the names of the attacks now.
Sleep.
Beware, my most powerful. Sleep. Ah. Oh. Got turned into a bunny.
Okay. All right. From the pendant, just oozes this almost transparent, wispy smoke, and in front of you forms. Let me find something.
Uh-huh.
A shape. Like that, and it just it appears to be a incorporeal creature that has long razor-like claws and gleaming horrific eyes.
Fun.
Which is kind of, huh?
Fun.
Yep. So that was his move, and now his summoned creature.
It's a ghost.
Gets to roll initiative.
It goes on the same turn he does.
Okay. Oh, that makes sense.
Alright. It attempts to swing at you with its claws.
Okay.
It's
gonna happen
on your turn. Skip me. Until I wake up. I think there's a round limit to it.
What?
Whoa.
I'm plus 17. Yeah, what?
Yep.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What the hell?
You take 5 wisdom damage.
What does that do?
If you reach 0, you...
You're brain dead?
Just like that. What does that do?
I've never dealt with wisdom damage before. What is it?
Basically, your will save will just get worse and worse. I mean, it doesn't have any thematic effects unless you want it to.
No, thank you.
Like, you won't just start drooling and, like, kind of drop your sword. It doesn't, nothing really happens until you hit 0 and then you fall into a temporary coma.
Jesus.
Okay, well, my wisdom is now at an 8, so.
Well, golly.
Fuck.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah, okay. Well, I've dealt with stamina damage before. I know how to deal with that, but I've never had wisdom damage. Oh, God.
Anything to do with wisdom, I'm staying out of that one.
Joey, your turn.
All right. I'm going to... Let's see. What's my range look like here?
Help.
All right, I've had enough time to survey the situation now that I saw what's his nuts running away, and I think I figured out which side of this fight I'd rather be on. So I'm going to, let's see, are Deadman, and didn't I use this token for another NPC, are they engaged in melee with Garrick right now?
Garrick is currently asleep. They're kind of looking at him and kind of just surveying the situation, like seeing, they're basically sizing up everyone they have to fight right now.
Okay. In that case, I think I'm going to ready an action. I'm going to point my pistol across the bar and just kind of hunker down, and the second anybody starts moving towards me, I'm going to shoot them.
Okay.
So you're going to Overwatch.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay.
And now that I'm right up next to Thorne, I heard her talking about how rich she is. Like, hey, don't worry there, Toots. Anybody comes near us, they're gonna get a face full of lead.
thank you.
You never want to fight in a fucking basement, because first of all, you're in a fucking basement.
What is that from?
That's from Inglourious Basterds.
Alright.
Cheese at the fuzz!
Right. Okay, I'm gonna get just over here a little ways now, because I heard those sirens.
Sorry, fire truck across the street.
Alright.
You have so many fires in the neighborhood.
Didn't I use this token for another NPC? Is just gonna kind of step forward, seeing his... he thinks that Dead Man will get Pata, and he's gonna kind of step forward and just kind of eye his prize, which is the sorceress. And at that point, Overwatch triggers, I guess, yep. If you want.
You're gonna
come here, fucker.
Between the eyes, man. Right between the eyes.
Okay, let's see. So I'm rolling 1d20 plus my ranged, which is 4. Plus my plus 1, because he's within 30 feet.
Very much so.
So, and I'm going to need it, because I just rolled a 4, so that's a 9.
Alright. At that gunshot, suddenly the patrons of the bar really start paying attention, because they just kind of figured...
There's people here?
Yeah, there are people here. I'm just going to, like, just... Hold on. People. Let's see if there's any tokens for people.
Isn't there, like, little bits of people? Ow. Everywhere, like...
Civilians are good.
I don't like...
I tried
civilians.
I tried civilians, and all I get are hot elf women.
Yeah, that same thing.
Maybe the clientele here is exclusively hot elven ladies. Maybe it's women's night. Ladies' night.
Hey, it's ladies' night. Oh, what a night. Oh, what a night.
Sure, I'll just add some people here and there.
Everybody's dancing.
It's quadruplets night, apparently.
Yes, this is quadies night.
All right, at the gunshot, people suddenly stand up, drop their food and drinks, and start freaking out and attempt to head to the back of the bar. So I'm just going to move them a little bit here and there. And the bartender freaks out himself, and he's going to try to clamber out of here as well. So I'm just going to move them a little bit at a time.
Guns are serious business, guys.
Yeah, they know what guns are.
Yeah, not swords and magic.
Guns don't kill people. I kill people.
Evidently not, because you hear the reverberation of your bullets on the tavern wall.
That was a warning shot!
Good recovery.
Actually, to be fair, I don't think any blood has been spilt right now.
Surprisingly.
Nope, just sleeping.
And wisdom.
Actually, yeah, roll Intimidate. See, roll Intimidate. Go ahead and see if that works.
Yeah, do an Intimidate. Scare them.
Then. Yeah, in that case, I was, I was gonna yell, I got 6 chambers in that thing! That was 1! Which, of course, is bullshit, but they don't know that.
Yeah, so use whichever's higher, Bluff or Intimidate.
Okay, let's see, I've got...
Charisma, so.
Yeah, they're both the same, they're both 6, so...
Fail.
That's either.
I rolled a 2.
Oh.
Plus 6, that's 8.
I'm gonna die.
Well, their sense motive, or perception. That was either sense motive or perception. I'm gonna say that's perception. On I didn't use this token. He kind of looks at you, and just kind of like raises his hands in the air and just kind of takes a 5-foot step back.
That's right. Raise your hands in the air like you just don't care about kidnapping this fraud.
Sounds like Joey was going, that was a warning shot. All
right, Potter's turn. If you want to know...
Some ass here.
If I want to know you?
If you want to know, Dead Man is dead focused on the gun, and he He seems really distracted right now.
Well, I'm just since Mook's taking a cat nap,
sucker punch it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna get dead man while he's not looking.
Okay.
So I'm basically, screw it. I'm gonna use flurry of blows.
Go for it.
So what do I need to roll?
So at level 1, flurry of blows gives you a -1 on each attack. However, since your strength is +3, you roll 1d20 +2.
Oh, so I actually take a hit from it? Oh, okay. Huh.
But you get 2 attacks.
Okay. Oh, damn it!
Wow, everyone's just sucking with the rolls today.
Oh, God, yeah.
Do I get my 1 do-over per session?
You got another roll.
Oh, okay.
That's what Floria Blows does.
Okay, please, please be good. Please be good. Oh!
Dead man mistakes it for a massage.
No!
Which puts him to sleep.
He is now moderately uncomfortable.
That's my version of sleep. Oh, god damn it.
All right. Dead man the uncomfortable next goes, and he notices that he is in between a bullet and a madman, just attempting to get that creak out of his back. So he's gonna turn around with both daggers and try to return your attacks. Let's see. Let's get the 20. Well, that one lands.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
Ooh. Oh my God!
Honey, what are you doing?
I rolled the wrong dice. I'm sorry.
Clearly.
I did was hit down twice on the roller.
Why are you rolling percentiles already? What did we do wrong?
Tavern explodes.
Okay, so I'll ignore that 99 damage apparently. No, that's his damage. See, I hit with the d20, and then the 99 was his attack.
Jesus.
Okay, so hold on. Is his damage is the d20?
No. Okay, he gets 2 attacks.
Okay.
He's got a dagger in each hand.
I gotcha.
That's why he's rolling for damage, to hit, because he's got a +2 in his main hand and a +9 in his offhand.
All right. I gotcha now. I was getting a little confused.
Okay. Yep. And daggers only hit for a d4, so Masako, you take 2 to your palm.
Oh, shit. Ow.
And a sting.
Satisfied that he drew blood, he kind of just licks his knife and just goes, yeah, there's more where that comes from.
You don't stand a ghost.
Thorn, your turn. Thorn, excuse me.
And there we go.
Thorn, it's your turn.
Alright, let's... I only got 1 spell left, and I don't really want to attack people, especially since I rolled, they're not doing too well.
You saddle up over to the bartender. Is there a back exit?
Where's the back exit? Back exit. Is there another tavern with stronger wine? maybe I can intimidate them and scare them out, like what Ben was trying to do.
Do you have prestidigitation?
I do.
Okay, prestidigitation is like the niftiest spell ever, because you can just kind of do like parlor tricks and basically anything you could see Jubilee doing in X-Men without doing damage, you can kind of do. Yeah.
Okay, so...
Make it look like a really powerful fireball and just like it's a light show.
Is prestidigitation just like a trick to scare people? Is that what it does?
It could do a little bit. It could do pretty much anything. It's actually like the best cantrip in the game.
All right, let's give it a shot.
So just roll an intimidate, and I'll let you know if they get scared.
Okay, so I actually do have to go to.
It's one of the skills.
I know I'm rolling to it. This thing is slow on me. Okay, so I got a
It's the Mac. I mean.
Shut up. Do I plus four or what do I do?
Yes.
So I do 1d20 plus four?
Yes.
Come on, Momma, we need some good rolls here. Doesn't seem like a good one. Fuck you.
Yeah, I didn't use this for a token and Dead Man the Uncomfortable. Both that look at your flimsy excuse of a fireball spell, and they realize that...
That's adorable.
And they realize that you're full of crap.
God dang it. Dang it.
Oh, boy.
Getting the hell out of here.
Am I going to wake up anytime soon?
Technically, you got a while. Oh, actually, I just forgot. I just realized that gunshot went off after you fell asleep, didn't it?
Yes.
Yes, it did.
You got a slightly, let's say you have a slight delayed reaction to stimuli, so go ahead and give like another will save. And I'll roll for Mook number 11 too.
What do I do?
One will save, so let's say
a. Or perception, whichever is higher, because Mook number 11 rolled really well.
Perception or will? I think they're going to be the same. Aren't they both wisdom?
Yeah, but if you've got a point in it, then you should be fine.
Didn't we determine that I'm like the only one who has perception?
Right.
I have perception.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there you go.
That's not terrible.
Sure.
Okay, so... Right, dead man, or not dead man.
Garrick.
What is your name?
Garrick.
You're awake. Garrick, yeah, you're awake. Okay. Whose turn is it? I'm sorry.
Am I awake? Or was the...
Yeah, you're awake. If you want, you can go next, but I'm going to move you down the initiative ladder.
Okay, well, I mean, who is next anyway?
Hanya would be next.
Yeah.
She can go. I'm after her anyway.
Okay. All right. She told me she's just going to swing at the thing in front of her. I think she gets a plus four?
Ghost.
She gets plus five. Okay. All right.
Oh, thank God. We actually get a good roll in there.
Oh.
Call it high or low. Okay. Sure. You seem to have hit it.
Yay!
What did I roll? You rolled 20.
Really?
Yeah.
Natural 20?
No. Just 20.
Oh, 15 plus 5. Okay, got it.
Yep.
Got it.
All right. I'll roll your what's your damage? 2d4?
2d4 plus...
No.
What's your strength? So plus six. 2d4 plus six. Alright. Alright, you swing and your blade seems to cut through it, like it seems to be in pain. Do you have a knowledge religion at all? Do you have a will? Give me another will save then.
Will?
Yeah. Okay. Can you guys hear her?
Kind of, probably.
Maybe yeah, there it is.
Yep.
Okay, she was standing right behind you when she said that, so...
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. She's running back and forth. I'm sorry. Okay. You realize as you slash at this phantasm in front of you that it doesn't appear to be an actual creature. So, You realize that it's not real, but that doesn't make its claws any less painful. All right. Garrick, your turn.
So all right. She rolled to find out that the ghost can actually be hit because it's a ghost.
No, pretty much, I'll just tell you, it's an illusion.
It's an illusion! Garrick, so did I get up from sleep?
Yeah, you're up.
Okay. I was wondering if I could, like, play possum and, like, try to trip the guy next to me.
Sure.
What would I roll for that?
That would be combat maneuver bonus. So you'd roll a d20, and I think for CMB, you add your strength, your BAB, and that's it.
Okay. So.
And it would be against his defense, which is not very good.
Sweep his leg. I'm sweeping the leg.
Why don't you just stab him?
Because I'm a cool guy. I don't need my sword.
Stab him. Oh, but sweeping the leg's so cool.
Because you gotta sweep the leg.
I'm just saying,
Master.
Nobody's done damage, so maybe you should stab him, but fine.
Are you sweeping or are you stabbing?
I'm sweeping the leg.
You're sweeping the leg. Go for it.
Okay.
Oh, not the prone. Come on.
You said strength plus
your BAB.
BAB, so that's plus three.
Yep.
Boom.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. I'm tired. All
right. You sweep his leg, and his feet go out from under him. And as he pratfalls to the ground, Garrick, go ahead and call it high or low.
Low.
All right, so low in favor of you. 1 second.
Luck be a
There we go.
Yeah.
All right. Well done. Okay. So as his feet come out from under him, he suddenly realizes he's in the air, and then he realizes again that his forehead connected to the table sitting right next to him, and he falls, just kind of pratfalls to the ground, and let's say he takes, that's a pretty good hit.
99 damage.
Let's say 99 damage.
His head exploded.
Let's say he wasn't ready for it, and let's say 2d6, because...
Oh my god.
2d6 non-lethal. One from, like... Essentially, that one is from him hitting the floor, and that six is from him just taking that table full to the face. And he lands on the ground.
Ooh.
Oh, whoops.
Nice.
Can you see his
yeah.
bar?
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
Okay. That is non-lethal, so he is dizzied and not in a good mood, but he is still awake.
When I get up, I'm gonna curb stop her.
Alright, Garrick said that?
Yeah.
Alright, since your leg sweep was a standard action, you could take a move action to stand up.
Alright, I'm standing up.
Okay. Since I didn't use this token, is currently in the surrendering position, he does not get an attack of opportunity on you. Alright. Bad Big's turn. He sees that you're pretty well occupied with the Phantasm, Alex, and... And he's going to take a full sprint in the opposite direction.
Oh. All
right.
So I'm going to move. Oh, sorry. I'm going to just drop him on another page. Joey, it is your turn.
I'm going to crouch down and reload my firearm.
All right. Good move.
Now they're going to know you were lying.
Cover me.
I didn't know this was a token. Now it's like, oh, well, it's time to fight again. Turns and takes a swing at Garrick. And what is his plus? form.
I take a table to the face, too. You want to take a table? Oh.
Shit.
Oh, crikey.
Oh, bloody hell.
I'm trying to remember what a battle axe does.
Oh, shit.
nag you a lot?
Alright. Oh. He, swings hard into you, and the battle axe digs into the front of your chest, and as you're in the middle of your sentence, do you want to take a table to the...
He does quite a bit of damage. I'm down to four.
Oh.
Yeah.
You gotta click your thing and go, like, it's the green one, right?
Yeah.
Minus seven.
Or just set it to...
I just set it. Okay.
Okay.
All right, Mook number 11 is awake now, and he sees that Mosco's back is turned. I'm not going to do any game mechanic. Oh, wait, he's on the floor, isn't he? Okay, so he's going to have to stand up, and when he stands up, Mosco, you notice him, so he's going to take a swing at you, but you get all of your AC.
Yeah, I'm basically going to use my acrobatics to my advantage here, and because I got, deck 7 on that, so...
Yeah, well, I just swing at your AC, and your AC is actually really good.
My AC is like 17.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm basically just gonna, well, since people like using this table, I'm just gonna use that to flip up onto the table. Backflip onto the table.
He swings really hard at you with his long sword, and you just kind of backhand the blade away, much to his surprise. Alright. Pata, it is now your turn. You've got a nearly unconscious dead man, the uncomfortable, in front of you. And behind you, some punk just tried to swing a long sword at you.
Well, okay, since I'm now on the table, I managed to get a little bit of clearance, so I'm gonna I'm gonna see if I can walk get over to dead man and basically kick him in the face.
Okay.
Kick him in the face and knock him out.
Well, he's kind of on the floor.
Well, okay. So, and you're... in that case, no, I'm going to jump on him and basically just chest stomp him.
Chest stomp.
Yeah.
No.
Curb stomp or elbow drop?
Elbow drop.
Right, I'm trying to find a good one for...
Thing, brother.
All right. So roll an attack roll then. I'll give you a plus one for having the high ground.
Okay, so that's is that 1d20 plus strength?
1d20 plus strength plus the one I'm giving you.
Okay, so roll 1d20 plus 4. Oh, come on!
Jesus.
Please give me a do-over, please. Come on.
It's the first
one do-over. My one do-over.
You want your do-over? Okay, I'll give you the one. But you gotta do the elbow drop and the Goku voice.
Okay. Elbow drop!
Better.
So that's your second one?
Yeah.
All right. 11. All of his AC is in his dex. And he's got crappy leather armor on. So his touch, his flat-footed is 11. So yes, you perform an adequate elbow drop onto his back.
Oh, thanks God.
He's knocked.
Oh, okay. Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, he's unconscious.
Nobody's killed right away, right? I forgot.
Well, also, I kicked him. He fell, so he's non-lethal damage.
Okay.
It's not we slashed him up.
Right.
Elbow drop!
I'm just gonna take dead man off the board so you can see him easier. But he is under you as you perform, like I said, your adequate elbow drop. And he gives a quick grunt of pain, and then as he extends his arms out, he instinctively lets go of his daggers, and then falls unconscious.
Blech.
All right. Now that Dead Man is out of combat, I'm going to go ahead and just move him over here. Thorm, your turn. All
right, let's see what my...
Oh, it is Thorn. I kept thinking it was Thorm.
No, it's Thorn.
T-H-O-R-N. Yeah, I should have known. That's how you spell Thorn. Well, I'm looking... I've got such a bird's eye view right now. Thorpa. That on the... on the table, it looks like Thorn, but I'm looking at the turn order and it says Thorn. I just,
it's actually Thorn with a P. The P is set.
It's Tom Marilyn, Bard to the Queen of Camelin.
Should I try Prestidigitation again?
Sleep!
No! I only got one more spell left. I don't want to use it. Just on these two guys.
I have a battle axe in my chest.
That's your fault. Well, I can either try to scare them away, or... Yeah, I might as well just try again. It's a free spell, anyway.
Prestidigitation?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm going to give him a slight bonus for seeing it the first time, but yeah, you can make another Intimidate or Bluff, whichever is better for you.
All the same.
Okay. Check. Alright, so...
Yeah, it's both
the same. Roll your Bluff, and then I'll roll his Sense Motive against it.
So it's just 20 plus 4?
Ooh.
Cool.
You did a much more impressive. This is the real deal this time.
Yeah.
All right. Well, like I said, he has a slight bonus for seeing this before, but he is taken aback by your sudden, seemingly great display of power, and he will take the typical minus 2 for being shaken.
The next one, I'm going to blow up the bar.
You hear a faint shout of the patrons. No, the booze.
Why is the...
By the way, they should be, like, gone by now.
This is kind of entertaining, but we're kind of scared. It's pretty...
Yeah, I'm just going to have them run out the back.
What really happens in this town, so...
Hey, this is a port town. Everything weird happens here.
Yeah, no one was really afraid until the gunshot goes off.
Yeah, everybody was fine with it. Magic, whatever. Oh, jeez, gunshot.
Yeah. Let's see. Okie dokie. Now it is Hanya's turn again.
Alright, am I smart enough to realize that thing was clearly an illusion?
Yeah, you're aware that it's an illusion. It's just, you know, psychologically, your brain still thinks it's real, you know?
This beer's good.
Yeah, like consciously you know it is, but your brain's like your fight or flight instincts are still just going off like crazy.
So I can't run through it to go catch the guy.
You can, it's just you can still attempt it. It's just at this point, you saw this guy essentially perform a pretty serious spell in front of you, and he's got a good distance now. And you would be caught kind of unawares, or kind of alone.
But I can. Did my sword slice do anything to this thing, or?
No, you're basically fighting something blank.
If I take a step back, would I provoke an attack?
Maybe. I can give you another will save, since you've kind of realized it.
Yeah, hold on.
Like, a concentration check or something to try to, like, will it away. All right.
That is a big fat nope.
All right, you're screaming, not there, not there, not there, not there, not there.
What?
But it seems to be there.
It's okay. I'm screaming, it's not there, it's not there. It's not
okay.
Just close your eyes. Close your eyes and fight it.
Well, yeah, I know, but like, I know that my attack won't do anything, right?
Yeah.
But I'm wary to back off because I don't want to take more.
Essentially, like, I kind of fudged a spell because, yeah, this thing would either have killed you outright or, knocked you, like, so helpless that this guy could have killed you, so I just kind of fudged the spell. I didn't want to have a player death right away.
Okay, I'm gonna back off then.
Or close your eyes and run forward because it's an illusion. You can run right through it.
Well, I already failed the will save to do that.
All right.
I'm going to back off then.
Okay.
Can I go 10 feet?
Sure.
No? Discretion is the better part of valor.
Start backing away.
All right, as you're
and
backing
cowardice
away,
is the better part of discretion.
It's not cowardice, it's survival instincts.
As you're backing away, the creature seems to be just kind of gradually just following you, but it doesn't seem to be hostile anymore. All right, Garrick.
Garrick is going to try to intimidate the guy who just put an axe in his chest because he has a male shirt on under it. So he's not, like, he's pretty fucking hurt, but he's not, like, bleeding out or anything. And he just, he's going to roll for intimidate and go, you want to try that again?
Turn off the sound.
Are you wearing your brown pants, too?
All right, so you're just going to intimidate him.
Yeah, I'm going to bluff. I'm going to use bluff because that's slightly better than my intimidate.
All right. What you gonna yell at him?
I will go, you wanna try that again? Cause I can do this all day.
Okay, go for it.
Four.
Oh, there we go. All right.
Yeah!
He just kind of shrugs and goes, all right.
not the answer I was looking for.
This is the sorceress is too scary to attack, but you seem squishy.
Can I... Is that my entire return, or can I throw a
punch? Let's say that was your move action.
Okay. Can I take a... I'll take a punch at him.
Yeah, maybe you should have done that to begin with.
Sure. I'll swing my scimitar.
I mean, like, your sword is drawn. You can...
I'll swing my scimitar at him.
Okay. At this point, it seems like negotiations are not viable anymore. At least on this guy.
Right.
Oh, you got him.
Yeah!
He was just wearing leather and he has no dex.
Okay. So my scimitar is 1d6 plus 1d6. It's just 1d6. Or is that with a strength modifier?
Now, you do get your strength modifier. I need to look up what weapon finesse does real quick, because you get your, I think weapon finesse, your dex would go into your to hit, but because you're a swashbuckler, you get your charisma bonus into your to hit.
Oh, yeah, I have a weapon-focused scimitar, so that's plus one for everyone, at least.
To hit, not for specifically damage.
All right.
Okay. All right, so yeah, weapon finesse, you get your dex modifier instead of your strength on your attack rolls, meaning to hit, you get your dex. However, since you're a swashbuckler specifically, you get your charisma instead. And then you get plus one for your weapon focus.
Okay.
So you've got, I think as a swashbuckler, you have full BAB, so you have plus one. And then you get, what's your charisma mod? Like plus four?
Plus three.
Plus three? So you get plus five total.
Okay.
Yep. Either way, you have hit him. And then for damage, you do 1d6 plus your strength.
Okay. Plus two. Okay. I only did.
Okay.
Reroll.
Can I do my...
You want your mulligan?
Yeah.
All right.
First battle. I think we're allowed to
do it. 1d6 plus 2.
On the left-hand side. Oh, my God.
Oh, wait.
On the left-hand side, you see all those tools there? If you click on the D20, you can see the last 10 rolls that you did. And you can just re-roll those instead of typing it in each time.
Okay. What the? What the? What?
What's happening?
Whoa.
See, Ben's just showing it off.
Oops, sorry.
Okay.
My bad. I didn't realize those were doing things over on the right.
Oh, damn. There you go. Max damage.
Yeah, yeah.
And then your strength is a 2?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So 8.
You, realizing that negotiations are off the table, you swing upwards at a great arc, cutting him from hip to shoulder. Blood flies into the air. However, this guy seems very, very hardy, and he just kind of takes a step forward after your sword arc is complete and just kind of whispers to you, "My turn."
Oh, I like this guy. It's going to be so sad when I kill him next turn.
All right. Token is going to swing at you again. And... Oh my God.
Got a 20.
So you're dead?
That's a natural 20.
Oh no.
Wait. It's critical. It's double damage.
Token, doesn't Bad Big go after Garrick?
Yeah, that's after Garrick.
But...
Oh wait, Joey. Oh, that's right. Oh no, it's Big Bad's turn. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Joey gets to take a shot at him first.
Yeah, Joey goes first. I'm sorry. Joey goes first.
Okay. So Bad Big's just off the... He's off in the nether now. He doesn't get a turn?
Yeah, he doesn't get a turn. The Phantasm, now that Alex is no longer engaged with him,
okay,
is just kind of like peekabooing at her.
Okay, well, in that case...
I'm sorry. It is Joey's turn. I'm keeping the D20, though. I don't care.
Damn it!
Okay, well, I'm shooting this guy, and I'm out for blood now. I'm using Deadly Shot.
Oh. Kill him. Kill him before he swings.
Yeah, kill him.
Yeah, so that gives me an extra 1d6 bonus damage that still applies even if I miss.
Yeah, half of it applies, but yes, you're correct.
Does it? Hold on, I'm going to look this up.
Kill him right
so
before...
So you roll your to hit.
But it's really good hit, just kind of like swings in front of me as he falls.
Beat the Roshi's! Mine's full-legged swing and then spin.
Okay.
Say beat the and then Roshi gets his ass kicked.
Mm.
So the bad guy's
stuck.
Roshi was the strongest
fighter. He grows huge. He's an old man, but he grows.
Yeah, but he's not the strongest fighter.
He's the most impressive.
Krillin's probably the strongest human.
But he's all... Krillin's wimpy. Wimpy looking.
Yeah, but he's stronger than Roshi.
Yeah, but Roshi's got the...
Just because he looks buff doesn't mean he's... Just because someone looks tough doesn't mean he's strong.
You're right. Dealing half the extra damage. Okay.
Yep.
All right. Well, cool.
Yeah, if you miss. If you hit, you get the full thing.
Yeah, okay. That makes sense. All right, so I got my 1d20 plus 5.
The masturbating.
It's a natural one?
It's a nat one!
It's a nat one!
Oh, dear.
Oh my God!
Redo!
Did you shoot me?
No, redo!
Or did you shoot yourself?
Do we, is
reloading
that...
Actually, one a natural one on a gun like that is bad news.
It's a misfire.
So I'll give you your mulligan.
Okay.
Yeah, because he's...
Yeah, because that would probably kill him, right?
Or put him down.
Yeah. At one hit point.
Okay. 13 plus 5, 18.
Okay, that hits.
Much better.
Okay, let me roll for damage here. So I got my normal 1d6 plus 1. That's 5 plus 1 is 6. And then another 1d6 bonus damage. 4, that's 10 damage.
Yeah, he's down. Damn. He doesn't get to hit me with that 24.
Ah, yeah. All right. As he leans in and whispers, you know, "My turn," he reels back with his battle axe, and it looks damn intimidating and real scary. You're fairly certain you see your life flash before your eyes, And then that flash is interrupted by the resounding sound of a gunshot that goes off, hits this guy in the hip, and knocks him down.
Everybody in the bar is like, yeah.
He's not dead yet? He's not down?
Oh, he's down. I said he was down.
Oh, his health looks like he's got some left.
He's got negative two, which is beyond the... Yeah. So he's still alive, but that KO'd him.
Okay.
I'm not...
That's a strong head.
I'm feeling...
Yeah, really.
All right. I am disappointed that I did not get that natural 20. I'm just going to see what would have happened. Oh.
Hey, no rabbit hunting.
Oh, that's so good. Why didn't I get to use it? Come on.
Stop it.
What, don't battle axe is crit times 3?
Shut up.
Because Zion protects guys what on dicks.
Yeah, battle axe is, I think, crit times 3. Damn it.
Or to the
yeah, Garrick, that would have outright destroyed you. You would have been chopped in half.
Freeze jaws!
Because battle axe is crit times 3, and you had... And that was max damage on my end. So, yep.
Yeah.
It was a good save from Joey. All right, Mook 11, not interested in getting shot at, elbow dropped, and or ensorcelled.
Ensorcelled.
That's a fun word.
Is going to run outside of the bar and retreat back to his hiding. One, two. Technically, he'd be right here. Gonna take the path of least resistance.
Yeah, bump into Hanya, and she whips around and stabs him.
All right, let's see. Mook 11 is gone. Pata, it is your turn.
Basically, I'm kind of like going. I'm thinking. I don't really know what trying to think what I could do, really, because it's like, well, I could like go after Mook 11, and if Hanya's right there, we could just basically flank him, so he's got nowhere to run. So I'm gonna go like 1 2 3 4 5. Yeah, that's I can do that.
Okay,
so
yep,
can I do flurry of blows again?
That's technically a full round action, and you had to take a move to get here.
So okay.
So you can do a standard punch, though.
I'm going to do a standard punch.
Okay.
Like, punch... I'm just basically just going to punch him in the... just punch him in the balls, really.
You're going to do a...
Because I'm just that frustrated. No, because after...
You're going to do an underreach.
After the elbow drop, I'm going like, yeah, I feel great!
You're going to do a Johnny Cage split and crotch punch?
Yeah!
Oh,
yes, actually.
All right. Now, like, all right, here's the thing. Called shots are a thing, and you technically met it. So, yeah, I'll just let you do it. Do your damage.
Okay, is that a roll? Hang on, I'm just checking my 1D strength body attack modifier. 1D6 plus strength, so yeah. 1d6 plus 3.
Okay.
1d6 plus 3. Oh. Forgot to do the roll. 1d6 plus 3. 5. 5 damage.
Oh. Oh. To the... Why?
I do have a critical of 2, so...
Okay. You didn't... Yeah, you did not...
I didn't crit.
Okay.
Oh, well.
Hold on. There is actually a rule. Let me see if there's a called shot to the crotch rule. leg, neck, vitals. I'm going to call this a vital.
Yeah. That's a vital if ever. All
right. A called shot to the vital leaves the target sickened for 1d4 rounds.
Sickened.
That makes
successful
sense.
Fortitude. Yeah. A successful fortitude save reduces this duration to one round. Okay, while sickened from the blow, the target cannot run or charge.
that fits perfect.
All right, let me do a fort save on this guy. What did he have to make? A fortitude save of what? The damage, I guess? I think it's the damage. So yeah, he is, let's say he makes that save, because a save of 15 is pretty good. So he's sickened for one round, but you hear a high-pitched...
Did we lose Masako from the call?
No, I'm here.
Oh, okay, weird. Okay, fine.
You hear a high-pitched from him, and he goes, why? Why did you punch me in the...
Not funny anymore, and... is it?
he just kind of hobbles.
Me in the dick.
He just kind of hobbles, holding himself and kind of like waving his sword. Like, mechanically, the only thing that happened is he sickened, which gives him a -2 on things. So. All right. Yeah, okay, so if you want to punch someone in the dick again, that's considered a tricky shot, and you take a -5.
Okay, so I can only do that. I can't do that again in the round.
No, you only get one attack per round, but if you wish to punch people in the dick again,
okay.
You take a -5.
What he's saying is that it's tricky to punch a dick, that's long and thick. It's tricky. Tricky. Tricky, tricky.
Okay. I punch this. Right. It's like.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
It was a successful punch.
Okay.
Dead man, the uncomfortable, is KO'd from the elbow drop, and it is Thorn's turn again.
It's your turn.
What could I possibly do at this point? Everyone's
almost
dead, basically.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're not much of a sorcerer.
Fuck off! They told me to pick these spells.
I mean, if you want, I believe you have magic missile, right?
Wait, I have a potion that I took from the guy.
Yeah, she's got an extra potion. You've been holding out on potion.
I know, I forgot!
What kind of potion is this that you have, that you've got in your satchel, or your belt, maybe, a pouch? What kind of potion? What does it do? Is it for healing? Because God, I need healing.
Yeah. I took it from one of those creeps that kidnapped me. Here, you can have it.
Why, thank you. I much appreciate it.
Do I have to roll to give it to him, or I can just give it to him?
Basically, you roll... You're administering him a potion, and you roll 1d8 and add 3.
It poisons him. 1d8 and add 3?
Plus 3, yes.
Okay.
Correct.
So, 8. Nice.
Okay. Is that how much he gets?
Yeah, that's how much it gets.
Yep.
Okay.
Yay!
I can move something off that guy. Okay, now I can get rid of that. Because I used one for my... That guy almost killed me, and then I took the other one.
Alright, Hanya.
Yes,
sir. Alright. You see Mook 11 run out of the bar, quickly followed by a pouncing Pata as he takes a cheap shot to his groin. It doesn't seem to be attacking you anymore now that you've given up the chase.
You okay? Well, I'm just going to ignore it and turn around and hit something that I can't hit, because I'm kind of frustrated right now.
Sure thing. You see Mook 11 not enjoying his predicament. I laugh at my own puns.
Predicament.
Oh, I see what you did there.
That hits him. You also get +2 for flanking with Pata.
Oh, I always say that whenever someone like comes up with a pun on my comments. I just go, I get it. That gets likes.
Yeah, you KO'd him.
I know. Well, you can roll it.
You can roll it.
All right.
All right. So as the guy is just kind of flailing his sword around, just kind of nursing his injury as best he can, you just kind of clip him in the back of the neck with the back of your blade, and he drops to the floor.
This has not been a good day.
What'd you do, 12? Jesus.
Yeah.
He's flopping around like a dead fish.
It's just like Gary's mod.
He's out. All right, and combat is over. The bar is clear.
The bar is closed forever because of all the damage that was done.
We didn't do that much damage.
How do you know? You broke a table.
I didn't break a table. A guy broke his face on the table.
I break the guy's nutsack.
It was all personal injury and not.
Now that's what I call a limit break.
I get it. Oh, it's funny when he does it.
No, there's a time and a place for everything.
All right. Now, Alex, after... my Alex, Hanya. After a minute of ending combat, the phantasm illusion just kind of clears from your mind.
That was not pleasant.
And from across the bridge, you and Pata can see what looks like at least...
Oh, Jesus, what are those?
City guards.
Oh, God.
What?
Do they look Arabic enough?
That's racist.
I almost thought they looked like little shrimps.
Oh, shit.
Walking forward.
Jesus, it's the shrimp army!
Hey, I resemble that remark.
You actually do recognize them. At the front of this escort of guards, you see Bashir.
Oh.
He's got his bow drawn, and the rest of the guards have their scimitars drawn as well. Uh-huh. But upon seeing you, Bashir calls off his guards and runs, stashes his bow away, runs forward,
yep.
And goes, "Oh, what's your Hanya, my desert flower."
Bashir, so good to see you so soon.
He looks around and he sees the unconscious fellow in front of you and looks at Pata and he goes, "Ah, Master Pata."
Mr.
Do
I know him?
He's the guy who hands you your rewards for turning in bad guys.
All right, okay, sorry. I just wanted to like double check.
Nice.
Afternoon, Bashir. Afternoon, Bashir. How is business doing?
Same Pata.
He looks at you beaming. Seeing the mook unconscious in front of you, and he goes, "Oh, it got much better after hearing this. I heard there was commotion in tavern.
Well,
many people come report it."
Well, yes, these guys are having conversations in various accents. I'm going through these unconscious guys' pockets back in the tavern.
Hey, I'm joining him.
Excuse me, I'm not a professional actor.
I'm having a beer after all this. Jeez.
Oh, I just finished
she's
number
having a
two.
Beer.
I meant an imaginary beer, but yeah.
Yeah, she meant in the game.
Yeah. She is behind the bar.
And that's Ben.
Oh yeah, I forgot that was a thing.
She just loots.
And
a,
just
she
like,
just loots
yes,
a.
Magic.
Leave a gold piece on the counter or something.
All right.
Okay. Can I loot the bar? Is there money here? Oh shit! Never mind. Bye.
Bursting into the bar come some guards, and yeah, okay, on the bodies, by the way, they're not bodies quite yet, because, you know, they're still breathing and have heartbeats, but on token, He had a fairly nice, well-polished battle axe that seemed to have been given, you know, a lot of love and attention, just well taken care for. Both Token and Dead Man were wearing leather armor that has since been soiled with blood and, in Dead Man's case, urine. And Dead Man had two also well cared for daggers.
Ooh, I'm a yoink them daggers.
Okay. He yoinks all over the floor. I'm just going to go ahead and remove Dead Man and Token.
All right.
And Mook 11. And these guards come crashing into the bar. They've got their weapons drawn and looking very scurry. Meanwhile, the captain is just kind of chilling and talking to the two bounty hunters outside. So how do you guys react after seeing six guards barge in?
Thank God. I have confirmed that they are still alive. They are still breathing. No murder has been committed here. I'll just be going now.
Self-defense.
I'm basically going to go to Bashir. It says, Bashir, you can let your guards down now because these guys gave us a really helping hand. These guys were joined with a big bad. You might have heard him going around, but he basically legged it after we just realized that he couldn't compete. Hanya here basically had to deal with a corporeal ghost entity for a long time, but yeah. Those guys in there, they're no threat. They actually helped us.
Bashir looks at you approvingly. He goes, okay, I understand. I will not arrest who you point out right away, although we may need you for questioning.
Well, you know how to contact me. So
it was I believe you should come with us, or at least point us in direction the direction of Big Bad that you mentioned.
I'm just gonna use my arrow. He went that away.
He is fast, very fast.
He traveled east down the street. My point down in the direction where the arrow is.
Okay, that's east. Okay, good, we're getting somewhere. Which direction is Nomadia?
The guards look at you as if you're just kind of like, to the north?
Ah, then to the north I shall go. Good day, gentlemen.
The one guard goes, hold, you may want to rent boat.
And how much do boat cost?
Boat,
keep in mind that my budget currently is zero.
You realize you need to cross the entirety of the sands and then take boat, and how did you get here?
That is a very good question.
You do not know?
I have several theories.
You are a funny little man. Okay. But I don't think you know how far away from home you are.
I'm sure that I do not.
Okay then. Maybe you should just lay low for a moment.
Alright. Garrick, what do you say to this?
Because I recently quit my job in a very spectacular and kind of fuck you fashion, I'm kind of just like self-defense. I had nothing to do with this other than defending myself and the people around me. Leave. I'm cooperating.
Okay. Alright. Well, taking at the word of both Hanya and Pada, they are not arresting you, but they do kind of want to sit you down and see, like, kind of debrief you and see what you know. We can just kind of skim past this if you want to just go over the big points.
Sure.
Is there anything special you want to tell them? Otherwise, actually, up to you. It's up to you what you
want
to do.
I kind of want Garrick to be a jerk, because, like, that's a window right next to Hanya, right?
Yes.
So I would have seen possibly what was going on out there. So I was like, all I know is that that girlie got scared of an illusion spell. That's what kept you from getting your bounty today. Oh, a level one spell.
You're a dick.
You don't know that that's a level one
spell. Well, what level is it? And
you're a fucking pirate. What would you know?
I basically just kind of BS'd a phantasm spell. Oh, okay. Phantasm is no joke.
Right.
Like.
Okay. So, I'll say a spell any sorcerer worth his own salt knows. I'm BSing that.
Okay, go for it. Yeah, okay, the guards kind of just nod, and Bashir comes in, kind of hears you talking
about people that you like, though, so I'm being a dick.
Yeah, that's what I said. They're helping you out.
Yeah, yeah, Bashir just kind of walks in and just kind of puffs out his chest.
I'm a little drunk.
Pretty big.
Drunk? You just had a battle.
Yeah, but I was still...
I'm pretty sure you're not wasted anymore.
I had two drinks before. Maybe Garrick is a bitch drinker. Okay, so he puffs his chest out and confronts me.
He puffs his chest out and goes, "No, what's your last name? If Shalzov was taken aback by spell, it was great and powerful. How dare you speak of my desert flower in such a fashion?"
I only know.
He says, hold. Hanya, I am defending your honor.
I would just like to interject that I feel that the lady acquitted herself honorably. Incidentally, is there any perhaps bounty or reward for bringing in these particular ne'er-do-wells? As I understand, I may be needing to hire a boat in the near future.
Splitting that bounty four ways here.
Halt!
But, tell you what, you can come on the boat with me.
I am a sailor.
My great friend. Yes, we are taking a boat as soon as you pay the bounty, and then we will be on our way with my pistol, my metal thing, my word of the day calendar, and these daggers, which are mine, that I own, that I brought with me here.
I slap him on the back and go, "You have yourself a hire." All
right. Bashir kind of looks at you and is kind of taken aback by your fast-talking, quick-witted ways. And he looks and says, "Oh, no, hold. You keep mentioning a bounty. I don't understand." Like, he looks around and says, "From what I know, this is just a bar fight gone wrong. And a wizard ran off. What bounty do you speak of?
Okay, now look, I know that this is what they have you do. You got a boss. He's looking over your shoulder. He wants to make sure that you're getting the good deal for the city, county, constabulary. I don't know what you... He wants you to haggle. I understand that. And I don't want you to go back empty-handed. So I'll tell you what. You take that. I'm going to throw a number out there. You take that 10 gold bounty. You take 2 gold off of it. 8 gold. 8 gold. There you go. That way your boss is happy, I'm happy, everybody's happy.
Bashir has never quite dealt with anyone quite like you. He kind of just looks around and goes, "Okay."
Me thinks you've been outwitted this time, Bashir.
He just kind of orders the guards to pick up the people around, and after receiving your story about these people, he just kind of haphazardly hands you some, like, 3 gold pieces, just kind of in confusion, and passes out 2 gold pieces to every other person.
Ooh, I like money.
He says, "I understand these are criminals. I do not recognize them specifically, but you can have reward for bringing in..."
Okay, all right, so I've got 2 extra gold. Cool. Sweet.
There you go.
I see what you did there, and I respect it. I was expecting 8 gold apiece. You gave 8 gold altogether, but you know what? I'm not going to fight you on it. You're a smart man. You have clearly outwitted me, sir.
Yeah.
Bashir is flattered, although confused.
And I giggle.
I'm just gonna go to like Joey. It's like, Joey, you don't. I believe that is your name. You in your many platitudes, you did shout out many words, and I believe Joey was one of them. You don't need to go.
It's a word that I often use.
It's probably best that you just leave it at that. He, Bashir here, knows everything that he needs to know.
You're a wise man, my friend. Would you like to come with me in the hiring of boats?
Well, I pretty much got nothing left else to do here, and I remember on my quest after my, very exciting episode earlier that, I am destined to go off on a great adventure to sort take out this inner peace that I once crave. And maybe a boat might actually be on the offering. So who knows? Yes, I shall join you. Because why the not?
Very sound logic there.
Hey, great adventures. Great. That's inner peace. That's good. That's good for everybody. What do you know? Who knows where boats can be found?
Bashir, still mystified, just kind of starts taking his report and says, for what your budget is, I would recommend the small world docks.
Oh, well, then it's a small world after all. That's out of canon humor. You wouldn't understand. Okay, let's go.
I was just nonplussed, and I'm just thinking, I'm just going to roll with this. A D20.
Okay.
No, that was a joke. I was gonna roll with this, a D20.
I get it.
Explain it again.
That was my long ass troll.
That's not a rim shot.
The longer the rim shot is, the joke. That's my joke.
All right. So I guess Garrick and Pata are now under the employ of Joey.
Okay, at this point I turn to Thorn. Now I do seem to recall you saying something to my associate here about your great wealth and the reward that you would be offering for his assistance in this matter. And as his employer, I will take only a mere 20% finder's fee.
Of course. Well, the best reward I have is a dragon's gratitude, and that is the rarest reward that I can grant anybody in this world, so thank you.
And, I am new in this town, village, city. I am new in this area. How many boats does a dragon's gratitude buy?
That is a good question, since I am not from this area either.
Well, given the attitude of, I'm going to say, roughly 50% of the locals that I have encountered, I am wishing to leave this area. And that's the other guys, the unconscious guys, not you. You're lovely, you're wonderful, you're a mensch.
I'll mute the mic. I'm sorry.
We have fun.
All right. At your talk of employing adventure, Bashir and the guards sort of lose interest. They kind of take the reports. Bashir kind of barks some orders around, and he dispatches two off in the south end of the tavern to go out. And the rest kind of take their prisoners and head back to the guard, basically the prison house, I guess. So, do you guys have any other business with here, or do you just kind of want to just dust your hands off and leave? Otherwise, it seems like 3 out of 5 people want to go on a boat.
A sail! I would like to get back home, because I don't know where the hell I am.
I don't know where the hell is home, but if it's in the same general direction as my where the hell is home, then I think we got a plan.
Where is your home? Where are you from?
Somewhere in the mountains.
is Thorn.
Oh,
like,
oh, what mountains we have like... in No Measure. It's probably those. Let's go.
Okay.
All right. I remember something about mountains in the prophecy. Maybe that might be it in No Measure.
You know, that is what they call me, speaking of. I do not believe I've introduced myself. Joey the Mountain, McGee's X, the children call me that, because I'm so very tall, as you can see.
Uh-huh.
By well, gnome standards, you racist ass.
You must forgive me, you're being rather presumptuous. May I introduce you? My name is Pata, and I am... One of the most reputed bounty hunters in this area.
Hey, how you doing, Pasta? I start flipping through my word of the day calendar for trying to find out what presumptuous means.
I get that a lot. But basically, I am a wanderer, and I am like you. I am out of my place, and I am seeking refuge somewhere. So, I am not like most of these people.
Well, you know what?
If you don't mind
punching some mooks in the nuts to get there, I bet you could find refuge in No Measure too.
I do like dick punches. Why not? That was rather exhilarating.
All right.
You should have heard him squeal. It was so gratifying.
Jesus.
we still no, just, B- Bounty Hunter Lake. You want to come on a boat? Let's all go on a freaking boat.
Let's all take a boat.
Hold on. Let me call Bounty Hunter Lady. Oh. She's getting stuff ready. 1 second.
Hey, Bounty Hunter Lady. You want to go on a boat?
The funny thing is that I think...
She wants to go on a boat!
The funny thing is, I think this is how the conversation would be. It'd be just like, hey, you want to get on a boat? Sure.
Well, let me ask my friend if they want to go on a boat. Hey, you want to go on a boat?
The guards just kind of ignore you and continue to
walk. I was joking. That didn't actually happen.
Alright. Well, that's a little disappointing for me, because Bashir is not aware that his desert flower is going to be leaving on a boat. So I don't get any of that. But whatever. Alright. So you all dust off your hands, pat yourself on the back for a job well done. It's okay.
Actually, there was one thing I need to know before I leave.
What do you need to know?
I need to know, how long have I been here? How long have I been searching this whole area for my
friend? Since you've gained a reputation, I'm going to say a little while.
Probably long enough
to realize that this is not helpful to you. Oh, that's great. Okay, so if you guys are just going to go on a boat, I will go ahead.
Should we really get on the boat? I did not like the last time I got on the boat with one of your campaigns.
Oh, it'll be fine.
No, it won't. Oh, okay.
It'll
guys,
be fine.
Guys, let's be smart about this, please.
Hey.
It's a boat's fine.
Hey, monster, here we go. Fine.
To the boat.
I assure you, we will be... If like my favorite show, Berserk, is treat me anything, we will be just fine.
Oh yeah, we'll be there lickety split.
Don't guys, you're making it worse.
Oh, I forgot about Berserk on the boat.
Shut up.
Did they get off the boat?
They're off the boat as we speak. They're not on the boat.
Oh my god, his one update per year, finally.
Now to be fair, they got off a boat once before. They met some mermaids, fought a sea monster, and then got back on the boat. So, you know, I'm just saying. Grain of salt.
Yeah, he killed. He
for years.
Sorry. Yep. And you're safe for encounters. We'll head you to the small world. Any encounters? Nope, you're good. And you guys just kind of make your merry way to the small world docks. Oh, whoops, wrong one.
Oh, he's here!
Oh, no!
And here you go. if you guys want to stop for the week, that's we've been playing for a little over 2 hours now.
Yeah, it seems like a pretty natural stopping place.
Yeah.
And the next episode. And plus, it gives me time because I did not. I had no plan for boat encounters or anything of the sort. I honestly kind of expected you guys to track down Bad Big.
Look at this. Look at this. Right, we're off the rails. Isn't this exciting?
No, I love it when this happens. So I get way more fun doing this. I can go right now if you guys want to keep going, but
yeah, we've been going for a couple of hours. I think that's probably a good place to stop.
No, that's good because I just thought of like three really good fun encounters right now. This is.
You guys aren't even tired to think you might regret it later.
Oh no, this is fun. Shut up. Okay, so next time you're on the boat, or at least looking for a boat.
Okay.
Oh, this will be fun.